first step is to determine if your yard has the correct drainage conditions for a rain garden. A simple percolation test, commonly known as a Perc test, is an important step that can help you decide. Dig a hole 6 inches deep by 6 inches wide. Fill the hole with water to the top and observe. Check the hole periodically and note how many inches have drained per hour. After 24 hours, if the water is gone, you have an ideal rain garden location. Remember, the ability of rainwater to infiltrate is an important function of your rain garden. If water is unable to drain, you may be creating a haven for mosquitoes, also known as our South Carolina state bird. If water does not perk within 24 hours, one option is to consider including an underdrain in your rain garden. This is a drainage pipe placed in the bottom of a rain garden. The pipe is perforated on top and solid on the bottom, and used to direct water out of the rain garden once full. Typically, underdrains are associated with more highly engineered bioretention cells and are not included in a residential rain garden. If your soils don't drain, another option is to create a backyard wetland garden. We won't be covering these types of issues in the virtual rain garden. You will need to follow recommendations from other resources, such as the Low Impact Development in Coastal South Carolina, a planning and design guide. This is also a good time to test your soil. The results of your test will recommend any necessary amendments you may wish to include in your rain garden soil mix so that the plants will have the ideal conditions to thrive. For best soil test results for a rain garden application, follow these few simple steps. Dig your 6-inch by 6-inch perk test hole. Before you fill your perk test hole with water, remove another 2 cups of soil from the bottom of the perk test hole. The soil should be dry at the time you take the sample. Place the soil into a plastic or paper bag and submit the sample at your local Clemson Extension office.